It's me. Come on, man. It's cold out here.
Did I scare you?
Yeah, you did.
Sorry.
Where were you? Didn't you hear me calling?
Yeah, no. I was working in my garage.
Well, what's going on? I got your message. You said you had to show me something?
Yes. Something big. Come with me.
What does it do? Get free cable?
No. It's a trap.
What kind of trap?
Okay. Well, you know how there's been reports of cattle mutilations and weird crop circles in town?
Uh-huh.
And people have been seeing strange lights in the sky at night?
What the hell does that have to do with anything? Wait. Are you saying that this is a trap to catch aliens?
Yeah. Let me show you how it works.
Oh, I gotta see this.
What? This goes 20 miles up in the sky. It attracts the aliens to the light like a moth to a flame. And then once they get sucked into the light, it sucks them right back down into the trap. Ta-da!
I have to hand it to you, Stu. You have outdone yourself this time. This is amazing.
You don't believe me. You think this is a joke?
No, no. I mean, this is pretty cool and all, but come on.
It works. I can prove it.
How?
I caught.
You caught an alien. Been eating some of those mushrooms that we found in your backyard there, Stu?
No, man. I am totally f***ing serious. I got one.
Okay. Show me. Oh, wow. This has got to be the most elaborate prank you've ever pulled. I'm impressed. What's under the sheet?
Go ahead and look.
For the record, if whatever's under there jumps up and scares me, I'm gonna kick your ass.
Here I go. Gotcha.
capable oxygen remaining.
G'day guys, and welcome to the first of six episodes of... G'day guys, and welcome to another episode of Science Plus, brought to you by Ditto Electronics. Now today I'm going to show you how to fix a malfunctioning Ditto Electronics shrink ray. If you've already tried restarting the shrink ray and it's still not powering up, then all you have to do is make sure that this knob is turned this way and the safety nozzle is clipped in just so. And then all you have to...
Looking at your shoe, it seems hard to fathom how it could be responsible for so much misery. I am Karthu of the Ant Kingdom.
Ant Kingdom?
Yes, ant. I'm an ant. This is what we look like face to face.
Well, can you help me get up to the...
You're not so big when you're small.
Where am I? And where are my clothes?
Your armor.
Armor? My clothes?
We have taken your armor from you. For years we have lived in this realm, eating only what we've found, on old plates, in bins, the occasional dead fly. And for years our numbers have been reduced. 3,498, that is the number of lives you have ended. Do not even bother. Those are reinforced fish bones.
What are they reinforced with?
Fish.
Wait, how come you speak English?
What should I speak? Chinese? Where would that get us? You would not understand me. Do you speak Chinese?
No.
Then why do you want me to speak Chinese?
You're an ant. How do you speak English?
We have heard people speaking. Learned what they have said, come to understand the language through observation, mainly in picnic settings. We know all the words for cheese. Brie, camembert, tasty, gorgonzola. That is a stinky cheese. But we love it. This is Anril. She was nearly squashed earlier today. Tell him, Anril. Tell him your story.
I was nearly squashed earlier today.
She was nearly squashed.
I'm sorry.
I was lucky.
There will be a trial at sundown and you will be found guilty. It will be a fair trial and you will be found fairly guilty. That was Ant, by the way. Anril doesn't speak Chinese either.
I know that wasn't Chinese.
Hundreds died today, smeared across the floor. Brothers, sisters.
I'm so sorry. I had no idea.
Gilgit was to be married on Thursday. The Ant celebrant who was to wed them was killed. Now Gilgit and Manu will have to find another celebrant, and you have to book them years in advance, especially in a colony our size.
Anru, please, I can help you.
Are you a celebrant?
What? No. If you let me get out of here, I can go back to my life, to my size, and I can help you.
Like you helped Finbar.
Who's?
Finbar, the celebrant. You squashed him.
I can give you food. I can provide safety. We can live peacefully. Please, Anril, please.
If I release you, how do I know you'll stay true to your promise? How do I know you won't just squash us all?
You can trust me.
You have to go now.
Anril?
Carthy won't see it the way I do. They sought to squash you, to give you the death penalty. You have to leave now.
Wait, my trial's already happened. What did my defense say?
I'm afraid you squashed your defense.
I was assigned a squashed lawyer.
Well, you shouldn't have squashed him. Now go.
Why are you helping me?
Because if we kill you, then we're no better than you are. And I believe you will help us.
Do you know where they put my clothes? My armor?
They burnt your armor.
My wallet was in that armor.
You have to go now.
Okay, thank you.
Easily tricked.
I didn't trick her. I just made a deal with her.
Oh, fantastic. What great news. In exchange for your freedom, you'll bring back to life the 3,498 ants you've murdered. Okay, great. Fantastic. Kill him.
Shit! Oh. Ah, fuck. Ow.
Ah. Alamon! You son of a bee!
Lucky!
3,500.
No. What will this achieve?
He has killed many, Anril. Do not believe that he will change.
What if he does?
Anril, I have him.
If you kill him, it will just be someone else stepping on us. But we will have tasted blood, too. The death won't stop. If you let him live, maybe he will change. Maybe things could be different.
You're a silly girl, Anril.
I'm a silly woman.
Sorry, woman. Sorry, you're a silly woman. Though perhaps not as silly as I thought.
Carthu?
3,500 and me.
No. Oh, and blood's most sad. I'm sorry, Carthu.
Hey, Matt, can I... I'm just gonna...
Oh, you've got ants.
Stop.
Somebody get me out of here! Somebody get me out of here!
There's a black hole in my house. And I don't know what to do. I don't know where it came from. I don't know why it's here. All I know is that it's certainly a black hole. How do I know?
Kitty! Kitty.
It looks the same from every single direction. And two, it ate my cat. At first, I thought it was nothing. But I got a second opinion.
I don't know what I'm looking at. I'm gonna touch it though.
So I left it alone. That's not to say I didn't find any use for it, however. I found ways of using the black hole in my favor. But after a while, as it had eaten my cat and eaten my friend, it too began to eat at me. So I decided to try and ignore the black hole. Like a piece of furniture or painting on the wall. No matter what I did, where I was, it was always there, eating at the back of my mind, till one day. taken over my every thought, my every waking moment, ringing in the back of my mind every single instance of each day, gnawing at me. I had to get out of there. But when I left, I felt I had missed something, a day, some time, some space. Couldn't quite put my finger on it. And then it hit me. I was already in it. I tried to run, but something was keeping me from moving, like mud, quicksand, like running in a nightmare. I tried to yell for help. But just like that, I was gone. Time slipping through the lens, fast forwarding like videotape. Every person I'd ever loved, every discovery I would have made, every human emotion I would have experienced, everything I thought was important, came and went. Lost to time and space. And so was I. And then I was alone. Utterly and irrevocably alone. Lost. Gone. Swallowed up by that contemptuous black hole. It was then a miracle happened. I saw the universe. Time and life and the whole of everything. Witnessing the beauty every sunset, every turn of the earth waxing and waning before me, birth, existence, death, consciously evolving before my eyes. I should have felt lucky, but I just felt lonely, and that loneliness hurt. The black hole and I had become one, a singularity, everything crashing in on itself, compounded by time. Was this it? Was this my new reality? Would I be okay with that? And if I was, what could come of it? Enlightenment? Sadness? Is there something philosophical in the exploration of man and his exceptional loneliness, like a Tibetan monk on a mountainside, figuring out all the world's...
Oh my God! Oh my God!